Hello, hello, hello. This is your girl, Miss Felicia Inspire. Today I'm going to be working on an alopecia transformation client. We're going to be performing a razor pixie cut. Today we're going to be using the Outre Indian Tarot 1, 2, 3, 27 piece in the color 1B. Okay, to begin with, I'm going to go ahead and prep her so that I can begin laying her tracks. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get a cotton pad and apply some alcohol. I'm going to be cleaning off her hair to remove any oils because I'm going to be applying lace glue directly to her scalp. And I have a lot of alopecia clients that come in. They have different levels of alopecia, different severities of it, and it's nothing to be ashamed of. Here in my salon, I do offer private sessions. I only do one client at a time just to give that client their personal time with you, because our hair is our biggest pride, so we want to make sure that we keep our self-esteem really, really high. So I make sure I give them their privacy when I'm working on alopecia clients. The lace glue I'm going to be using today is the Ebon Wonder Lace Glue, and you can get that at your local beauty supply store or you can get it on Amazon. Now I'm going to be using a wood stick to apply the lace glue directly to her scalp. I'm going to only apply two layers of glue. When you are applying the lace glue, don't worry, this is not going to harm the scalp. She don't have any hair, and so it's not going to harm her scalp at all. She's not allergic to this glue. We've used this glue numerous of times, so just make sure that your client isn't allergic to lace glue before you apply it directly to their scalp. And even when you're applying the lace glue, you can apply as many layers as you want. As many layers that you put down, the longer lasting that you'll get out of that quickly. On this quickly today, I'm only going to be applying two layers of glue because my client gets her hair done every 2 weeks. So we're not going to put a lot on there. I'm only going to apply the lace glue to her temple areas and the back, mainly because you don't want the back to lift up, and as long as you have glue on the temple area, you should be fine and you won't have a lot of cleanup to do when you remove the quick weave. Don't worry about if the glue isn't completely clear. As long as you blow dry it enough, then you should be fine. We're only using it to get tacky so that the paper that you're going to apply will adhere. Now I'm going to be going in with my black wrapping paper, and I'm going to apply it to her entire head to make sure that we protect her scalp. Okay, so I'm going to begin gluing the paper down. I'm going to be using the 60-second glue. And personally, this is what I like to use because it dries fast. You don't have to use a lot. when I'm going in with the paper, I usually just put one dab of glue on each end and I glue paper to paper, and that's to make sure that you're not getting the glue on the scalp. Now I'm going to go in and cut off a little bit of the excess paper around the ear. And sometimes the paper tends to roll around the back and around the edges, and all you have to do is just go in and cut that off. Sometimes I don't put any paper down close to the ear, only because when you're going in to lay your tracks, you want to make sure that your tracks are laying flat, and also that's where you put the lace glue. So when you lay your tracks down, it's gonna be down like really flat. So now I'm going to begin laying that first track. So I'm going to put my 2-inch on the bottom, and I only do about 2 rows, and that's only because you want that last track to kind of give you more room for when you're cutting and you don't want it to flip up. Normally when you're laying those tracks in the 2-inch, you're going to use about one of the longer pieces, and that'll cover 2 rows and enough to do your sideburns. Then you can resume using your 1-inch. And from here, you're going to just go ahead and lay those tracks in a horseshoe motion all the way till you get to the crown. You'll still go all the way up until you get to the temple area. Okay, so in the beginning I scratched my tracks, and basically all I did was use my flat iron to straighten out the 27 piece tracks. Because when you open the hair, they have that deep curl in it, so it's kind of hard to lay your tracks. So with this, all you would have to do is just lay your tracks down, and when you flat iron them flat and straighten them out, get that curl out, it'll help you to move quicker, apply your glue so that you don't have glue on the ends of the hair. Yeah, so you can space your tracks out even more, so that you don't have your tracks all bumbled together. Be sure that when you apply your tracks, and if you see any strings that have to be cut, make sure that you cut them, because when you get ready to razor the hair down, all of those strings are going to show. And basically all they are strings where they've sewed the hair to the weft. And all you have to do is just cut them and you should be fine. Okay, now that I'm in the crown, or at the temple area of the head, I'm going to leave a dip where I'm going to do the closure in the back So you want to make sure that you do not go any higher than the pinpoint of where you want to put your closure. Even though I'm continuing to add more tracks, I use my thumb to kind of press down where I don't want the tracks to go any further, because that's where the closure will lay. So all you have to do is every time that you add another layer, just put it down in that same spot where you want that closure to lay. Now that you're done laying your tracks, you're going to get a comb, a small tooth comb, and you're going to comb out and blend all of that together before you begin laying the tracks in the top. Now we are going to take that last bundle, your longest length. We're going to start tracking the top from left to right, and then we're going to go in. She wants a little color. She wants to spice it up just a little bit, so I'm going to throw in a couple of red pieces to spice it up. So I'm going to go off camera and I'm going to track up the top, and I'll be right back when we get to the back. So here we are in the back where you're going to be using your closure. So you're going to go in a circular motion, well, a U-shaped motion, all the way until you get a small circle. For this particular style, I'm going to be using the closure piece that comes with the hair, and all I'm going to do is just use my flat iron to flatten out the closure, and all you'll have to do is just glue it on. Now I'm going to use the Ebon Wonder Lace Bond adhesive spray, and I like to use that spray to kind of help lay down the closure. It helps it to lay flatter, and it helps the glue to dry quicker, and it gives it that extra firm hold when you put that closure in. You're going to go ahead and comb all of that out, comb the hair in the direction that the tracks was laid, because we're going to get ready for the fun part. It's time to style and razor cut the weave down. Today I will be using a razor comb, and you can find that at any beauty supply store online. It's just a regular razor comb that I like to use. So we are going to begin razoring down this quick weave. When you go in and razor, please make sure that you're being light-handed. Don't go in and jab at it, or you will expose your tracks, or you may cut too much. So just be light-handed and take your time. And it's normal when you are using the razor comb, it's normal to have to switch out your blade. So you need to make sure that you have Darko replaceable razor blades, because in a normal quick weave, I normally run through about 4 or 5 razors, because if you try to use a dull razor, then what's going to happen is you're going to start to shave down. You'll start to see white cuticle hairs coming out. So you're going to try to make sure that you're using a fresh razor, making sure that it's sharp, making sure that it's not dull, and that you're going to make sure you have a smooth transition when you cut the hair. Now it's time for me to switch out my razor blade, because the other one has went dull. And you can find the replaceable Darko blades on Amazon, and I'll make sure that I put that information in the box below so that you can find all of that and make sure that you have all of your replacement blades, because I can promise you you're going to need them. And while you're cutting, if you have longer nails like I have, then you can kind of filter through and kind of comb through the hair with your nails to make sure that you're straightening out the hair how you want it to lay and what needs to be cut. But if you have a comb, you can use that as well. And this style is one of those styles where it's very low maintenance. You don't have to do much to it. You can kind of comb it and you're out of the door. And most of my older ladies get this style because they don't want to have to get up every day and curl their hair or do anything to their hair. And it's quick and simple. It's edgy, you know, and it looks very natural. So once you get it down pat and you get the razor down pat, if you're a beginner, this you will come to love doing styles like this, because it's very fast, quick, easy money. Now I'm going to apply my shine and use a wide tooth comb to kind of style and rake the hair. And there she goes. Now we are going to do a taper, edge up the hair, and do your final touches, trim down whatever needs to be trimmed. and get her on out of the door. I'm going to use Bedhead Hardhead as a holding spray to tame the frizz. Okay, we are all finished. This is the final product. Just want to thank you for listening and thank you for sitting in on this video, taking time out to learn something. And if you learned something and you like the video, make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Make sure that you like and share this video. Make sure that you hit the notification bell so that you get your notifications first when I make an upload. Thank you.